MTN, Vodafone, Tigo, and Expresso. Expresso is CDMA, not GSMA. However, we recognized the value of the event and many of the issues that came up in Barcelona are not necessarily GSMA sort of limited. They are issues that are of importance even to CDMA operators as well. There are things that we all could learn on the back of the discussions that went on in Barcelona in terms of policy, the policy and regulatory regimes, and how, and recognizing the socio-economic impact of mobile telecommunications in, especially in Africa, in the context of what is going on around the world, you know, global trends in mobile telecommunications. So it's for that purpose that we thought we should have this event, and session just peek back on Barcelona and have a small little discussion on the key takeouts from Barcelona. And so after Magnus's presentation, there will be a panel discussion comprising, comprising Bruno Roy of Airtel representing the mobile telecom industry, maybe some of the World Bank, Mr. Albert Inifo, regulator, and we might have a journalist representing the people. And it will be moderated by Mr. Arthur Gordon. And there will be a Q&A session as well. Now, just a couple of backdrop. In 2011, in terms of the socio-economic impact of telecoms in Africa, mobile telecoms had a direct economic impact of 32 billion, including 12 billion in taxes. 12 billion in taxes in sub-Saharan Africa. It created 4.4% of the region's GDP when adding the effects of mobile technology on workers' productivity. And it created over 3.5 million jobs in the formal and informal sectors. Penetration is growing, but it still remains low. In Ghana, for example, we quote 100%, but we also are aware of the impact of multi-SIMs. And so there's still some headroom, especially in rural communities, where there's a huge gap that needs to be addressed. We believe that this can be done in partnership, as a partnership between policymakers, regulators, operators, and how we utilize or fund universal access funds, maybe in combination with tax incentives, in order to ensure that the investments made, in order to ensure that network operators are encouraged, incentivized to invest, put infrastructure in communities where there are communities in Ghana, in Africa, where if you consider the current situation, the energy situation, in some communities actually cost you more because you spend more fuel driving the vehicle to take the fuel to the cell site. Because all these cell sites, over 3,000 cell sites, all of them have to be backed by industrial size generators. Over 3,000 of these that have to be kept running when the power goes off. And of course, even sometimes when the power is on, the quality of the supply is not good enough. And that sometimes affects the quality of service. But some of these places are so remote that the amount of fuel, the truck that is taking the fuel, uses is more than the fuel is taking. But you've got to do it because because the people in those communities also have to be connected. There are costs associated with right-of-way, laying of fiber, assemblies that want a lot of money before you can pass fiber through their communities that we are working on. One of the issues that the chamber has been successful in dealing with together with the regulator is fees charged by assemblies that in some instances used to be 200, 300 times more than what they charged other industries in a similar category, such as banks, oil companies, mining companies. But to in partnership with the regulator, this matter is virtually behind us, for which we are thankful. So I'll keep my remarks short, merely as introductory remarks. And I have the pleasure now to invite Mr. Albert in.